Hey, this is Ryko, and this must be part 15 of the Goldeneye playthrough. Quite near the end now, 3/4 of the way there. And this is the only mission in the game that I do not like. It's the only one I have a problem with, really. And although I'm not one to knock games for their graphics, graphics are the main reason I don't like this level. And there are a few games on the N64 which can create open areas and make them look really good. I mean, Zelda, Ocarina of Time, that's one great example. I mean, Super Mario 64 can do it quite well too. But this particular level demands a lot of foliage, and as a result, draw distances are very poor. It just kind of spoils things. I mean, as you saw a second ago, I took out a turret. I wasn't even trying to aim at it. It was just a fluke shot. I couldn't even see it. And that's just made things a lot easier for me at this point. And the same can be said when attacking enemies generally. I could be shooting someone up close here, and then someone well out of my sight can spot me and start opening fire at me. Which, it's quite annoying. It does spoil it. I mean, it's not much you could have done in this game. I mean, it follows the movie quite closely in terms of locations, and so this level had to be in the game, but it was really asking a lot for the N64 to pull this off at all well. And, well, the results weren't that amazing, really, but never mind. Another point about this mission I don't like is its structure. I mean, it's like, to me, it's like four mini missions. You locate an area, you destroy an item in that area, and you kill all the guards in that area, and then you move on. And you repeat that four occasions. And that's it. I mean, it's a bit repetitive. If it was all one location you were working towards, it'd be alright, but that's how I see it. I see it as four mini missions. But I gotta stress again that this is actually one of my favourite games of all time, even though all I've done in these playthroughs is moan about the AI, or in this case graphics, or even mission content. But believe it or not, it is one of my favourite games. I guess I'm just too much of a moany gamer. But anyway, I'm going to moan about the AI again, because this is an interesting scene. AI in Goldeneye has a tunnel vision. Well, by that I mean, unless they can directly face you without any obstacles in their way, whether it be a hole, a fence, or whatever, then they won't shoot at you. Like you've just seen here with Xena. She could have shot me from across the bridge. She could have shot me while she was on the bridge, but she chose to run all the way across it and come directly at me. I mean, well, it's pretty stupid, but for its time, you didn't notice these things. You weren't used to AI reacting in such a way. You weren't used to AI acting at all with this sort of level of intelligence, which now looks very stupid. But yeah, that's a... Once you understand that, the AI has tunnel vision, you can abuse it in many ways, especially on some of the later levels, which have railings everywhere and you're following tiny routes. I mean, I'll talk more about that as we come to them later on. It's not a very interesting fact at all. Anyone who owns this game is going to know it already, but there's a multiplayer mission, or multiplayer level, I should say, called The Caves. That's pretty much what it's based on, the end half of this level, really. They've just cut a chunk out of this jungle mission, and then added and tied up a few routes. But I guess that kind of How am I going to say this? I can assure you, even though the multiplayer mode in Goldeneye was great, I mean, it was excellent. It was put together quite quickly. And so, for that reason alone, I guess you could say this is one of those shoot 'em ups that doesn't suffer from having a multiplayer mode included. I mean, the single player mode doesn't suffer from an inclusion of a multiplayer mode. There are many other games out there, unless those games are modded, like Half-Life, they have mods designed and stuff specifically for multiplayer, then that game is likely to suffer. But this is one of those games that just doesn't fit that rule. It's one of the few games, the only game I know of, in fact. An FPS will either be a good multiplayer game or a good single-player game. Rarely ever does both. And if developers try to do that, then one or the other, or both, will suffer. I.e. Metroid Prime 2 and Killzone. Anyway, enough of my ranting. We've come to the end of the video now, I'm just rushing through. Hope you weren't bored. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next mission. Goodbye.